All right, so first, I want to say the ATF denied me on two of my suppressors. And if you look at the date, it's in July. And it's like, what, October now, and I just got these. Come on, ATF, you're really cramping my style here for building up my arsenal. Anyways, so what I want to talk about today is what it's been like the last 2 years owning my C6 Z06. So, you know, after you own the car for a while, so the newness of it wears off and you get to kind of get a good feel for it. So figured now would be a good time as we're coming up. It's not quite 2 years yet. It's like we're coming up though on 2 years and just sort of talk about what I've found that I really like and what I don't like about it. So first I'll talk about the things that I like. I really love the power and the performance of it. So I know it's not a, you know, like fast car as far as like, you know, going to be messing with all those, you know, high horsepower like twin turbo Lambos and GTRs, but you know, as long as you're not in Texas, it's still as is probably faster than about 85 to 90% of what you see out there. So it's nice to have that, and so that you still have that kind of in like your back pocket, so it opens up some other cars you can have. Like, so I also have the M3, which obviously isn't nearly as fast as, you know, you've seen, and you know, it makes it so you have a kind of a variety, but you always have that one that, you know, is going to be, you know, the fast car. The other thing I really like, and I knew this before because I've always liked American V8s, but I really love the sound of the LS7. Holy shit, guys. It is just a glorious sounding engine. Just every time you fire it up, everyone, you know, everyone that hears it loves the way it sounds in person. It's super, super loud, obnoxious. All of my neighbors dislike it besides like the one car guy, so he's cool with it. The other thing that I think, and this is probably maybe one of the things that, you know, if it's more of like a long-term car for me, is that I really like that it is probably the last big displacement V8 out there. Just as with, you know, like emissions and things of that nature, the engines are getting smaller, a lot more forced induction, which is cool. I love forced induction, but just it's nice to just think that it's, you know, this is probably the last one that I don't think we're gonna see another 7-liter, you know, V8 out there anytime soon. Especially, you know, one like the push rods, and adding on top of that this is a true 6-speed, and I think it is a car that will hold its value. It's not gonna be like some sort of collector car by any means, but I think it'll hold its value and isn't going to lose a ton as we go forward in time. And then one of the other things that I've really liked is it's really cost effective to drive. You know, with the M3, I'm always sort of thinking like, shit, if I break something, it's going to be really expensive to fix. And I don't really think that with the Z06. I never really worry about that. I was looking and a new LS7 from GM is like $11,000, and it's a pretty stout motor, you know, some quirks here and there, but it, you know, it's still a Chevy, so it's not that expensive to fix, so I never worry about it, versus, you know, like the M3, which had like the bearing issue. Mine have been fixed and replaced, but that still would make me really jittery about driving it and flooring it, thinking every time, like, this could be the day. So I guess kind of to move on to some things that I've, you know, after getting used to the car that I'm not such a big fan of, this one sounds kind of weird, but it's going to be really hard to explain, I guess, to people who don't own one of these cars, is the ride. Now, the ride quality itself is fine. It's not overly, you know, stiff or anything like that, and I don't know if it's just the way, you know, my car is set up. I haven't been in a ton of other C6 Z06s, and all the ones that I have been, you know, had the stock wheels on it for the most part, and I replaced the wheels in the first couple weeks, so I don't really know if it's just me specifically, but it really, you know, I've mentioned in some other videos too, it like really tracks all over the road, grabs all of like, you know, the you know, unevenness of the roads, any cracks or grooves, just pulls and goes. So, I mean, there's a lot more like active, like, you know, a little bit like steering. You can't just sort of like just zone out and drive it. I realize part of that is because, you know, the Z06 was set up as a track car, so it's not going to ride like the M3, which is a just dream. But, you know, that is something that kind of is a deterrent as far as, you know, do I want to take it to go like, go get beer or something like that, or go get food or something like that. That's probably the biggest thing for me, is just of why I don't drive it a lot more than I do. Another thing is the visibility. And it's nothing to do with, you know, the tint on the car, like, that's fine, but it's the, I've driven plenty of other, you know, C5s and things like that before I got this, and I never had any trouble seeing out the back, but with this one, I don't know if it's the way that how low it sits, but it's really difficult to see out the back, so it makes parking lots a little interesting, but, I mean, again, it's not a huge deal, but just something that I have noticed of, like, you know, as, you know, owned the car, it's something I probably wouldn't have noticed, you know, initially was going to go check it and test drive it. And I think the last thing, for me, of what I haven't been a huge fan of, is it's not very unique. There's so many other Corvettes out there, and I know that I was talking about, like, annoying things that Corvette owners do, but they all think their car is unique, but it's not. I won't even say there's probably, like, close to, like, 100,000 C6 Z06s out there. Maybe not be quite that much, but it's got to be close. And so you really, it doesn't really have that kind of, like, wow factor. I mean, it's a great-looking car when you see it coming down the road, but, you know, it is still just a Corvette when it comes down to it. The Viper, and then even, like, the Supra, it definitely attracted a lot more attention, and just, like, when you, like, sort of open the garage door to look at it, it was just like, ooh. But, and that's part of, you know, why it is so, you know, like I was saying before, cost effective, is just because there are so many made, and they're, you know, made fairly cheaply, that a lot of people own them, and they're just great bang for the buck, so people love to have them. So that's kind of it. I appreciate it, guys. Overall, though, great car. Would highly recommend anyone to pick one up if you can. I love it. I was actually offered a pretty good amount of cash for mine. I thought I was going to take it. I actually accepted it, and then I drove the car, and then I was like, I just don't think I can, because I don't know what I would replace it with. Everything else that I like that would be in that sort of performance realm is more than double the price, and just right now it's not something super economical that I want to attempt. So I appreciate it, guys. So thank you, and here's to another year of owning the Z06.